Good afternoon, Professor Kaplan.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. A digital warm welcome in 's-Hertogenbosch. You're now in Lausanne or Venice?
No, I'm in Lausanne.
Lausanne, okay. And how's life there at this at the moment?
Difficult, like everybody else. I mean, everybody is not really sure about what is going to happen. But it's great to be with you. I'm so sorry not to be physically with you, but at least I mean we have ways of sharing this event together through digital means.
Yes, yes, yes. Okay. Are you familiar with our city?
Yeah, I never visited, but I read quite a lot of things about it. But that's definitely one of my next move, if we can move again.
Okay, you promise, of course. I've just introduced you in Dutch, and I reassure you, I haven't lied a word. Thank you for being our guest in our Congress, and thank you for giving a short brief word to our conference visitors. The digital floor is yours, Mr. Kaplan.
Thanks a lot. Well, welcome to this session. I mean, it's a great pleasure to be with you. It's also a great pleasure to see, I mean, the dynamics you have in your city. I'm extremely happy that you can now join the Time Machine network. You know, it's a story that started really city by city, I mean, through local dynamics, first one, then a second, then a third one. Each of the city brought very nice institutions in. And now at the Time Machine organization, there's more than 600 institutions which are members. So it's a growing and growing family. They're all sharing something in common. They want to have, I mean, the past being more present, essentially. And they think that technology, but also citizen, but also, I mean, new ways of actually doing mediation in the city can play a big role in this. The idea really is to be able in every day of our life to have the past one step away, extremely easily accessible, not only in books or in photographs, but actually as a dimension which is always present. I mean, I want to be able to walk, I mean, in your city and just with a slider see how a place was, how it transformed over time. I want to be able to understand who was living maybe 200 years ago in each of the house, follow these family trees, understand about their stories. It changed completely, I mean, the experience not only of the city, but about, you know, the everyday life of walking with ghosts as a remembering that we are not just in that particular moment of time, but we are in a much longer trajectory. Technically, it essentially means that, I mean, all the cities which are joining the Time Machine in some way or another try to aim for building something that we call a mirror world. I mean, a mirror world is essentially a kind of double of the city where you have all the digital informations, not only about the present, but also about the past. And you can use, I mean, this data sets, but that, let's say, special data sets to create new types of experiences. It's very important for scholars, I mean, the ones who are studying the city, because they can share their results, they can compare all the information which have been available on the city, but it's also very important for the creative industries, new forms of mediation, new forms of game, new forms of mixed reality, which is between games and the normal life. It's also very important for the city planners, I mean, the one that wants to design the future of the city. I mean, having the possibility of benefiting from the past, of being just, let's say, one click away and one slider away is extremely important for making good choices, for not destroying the past, and for also having a bit of spirit, I mean, when they actually imagine the life of the future citizen of your city. So to do this, and as this is a shared dream with some variations, of course, but in many cities of Europe, we have created the Time Machine organizations. We've also received money from the European Commission for 1 year to prepare a 10-year plan. And essentially, the role of the Time Machine organization is helping all these dynamics, these local dynamics, to benefit from the experience of one another in the first place, exchanging technology, exchanging know-how, exchanging exchanging experiences, and also progressively scaling up from, let's say, the state-of-the-art technology, what can be done now, what can be done in 1 year or 2 years, but maybe also to a longer horizon. What are we going to be able to do in 10 years when we will have new artificial intelligence techniques, new form of mediations, new types of understanding? And the idea is walking this path all together, sharing on the short term, but also planning together on the long term. Concretely, it means people and institutions in the time machine are working on new digitization technique, faster, adapted to new type of material, objects, city as a whole, combining various forms of techniques that permit to see inside objects, for instance, inside books, digitizing books without opening them, that sort of things. It's about, of course, new annotations, collective annotations technique. I mean, how do you manage to progressively map the past, connect the past? You see it as a system where maybe a detail in a painting is recalling another detail in another painting in another city, where a photograph is presenting a particular perspective on a given street, which is then seen again in an engraving. That sort of articulation, this is all done by new tools that permits to search massively in data sets, but also to annotate it in a given way. There's, of course, many things which are becoming possible now through artificial intelligence, new way of searching inside images, inside videos, new ways of automatically sorting documents, navigating in millions of images. Just think, usually maybe an art historian may know maybe 10,000, 20,000, 30,000 images. We're coming now with data sets which have millions of images. So we need the help of machines to sort our way in these a labyrinth of data. And obviously, also, all new ways of experiencing, I mean, these big data of the past, as we call them, augmented reality, immersive space, new way of mixing the real and the virtual. I think we're going to have a big change in the next 10 years in that respect. For quite a long time, these were space which were not really encountering one another. You had the internet on one side, the web, with the social network it started to be mixed, but what is coming now is a much more precise entanglement between between these different spaces. So ways to benefiting from this progress by sharing what is done, by actually doing research together, ways also of planning for the future. There is let's say a collective process for designing the time machine which has been started. Essentially, it's inspired by the way the internet was built. When you think about how can we build very large machine, I mean, global machine, planetary scale machines, then you need to find ways to reach consensus, to discuss maybe with a slower pace the good solution. And so we took inspiration on what worked with the internet, which is a mechanism called a request for comment, very simple text, which are not standard. I mean, they are collectively negotiated solution or technological solution that can progressively be shaped together. And we started, I mean, this process of collective writing. So if there are some potential writers or people that want to participate, you can participate being a writer, being just helping in organizing the process, or being a reviewer of the of this type of writing. The Time Machine organization is helping also some project that wants to benefit from European funding to connect with other projects in Europe. We have our project scouting system. Don't hesitate to use them. And finally, we have specifically a series of services for what we call the local time machines. I mean, your city will start with a series of projects. Each of these projects, if they are registered on the time machine platform, could not only share their data, benefit from connection with other projects, but also being maybe more visible beyond a local or national circle, but maybe at a European scale. We've seen, quite a lot of beautiful projects in Greece, in Spain, in Germany, which are not known from in other countries. It's still a very segmented domain. What we want is breaking those silos and permitting progressively some of the excellence that may happen in one city to be connected or in relation with the experience in other cities. That would be really a very strong sense of a collective effort at European scale. So this is extremely exciting to see. I mean, this local dynamic, to see that things are moving quite nicely here. I wish you really, sorry, the best. That's not the COVID, but the best of luck for the future. And I really wish I can travel to come and see the various progress in your various projects and how we can connect that with the rest of the prospect we have in Europe. Thank you very much.